Hello, everyone. What holiday are we celebrating today? Easter. Easter is one of my favorite holidays because we focus on things that are new in the spring, new life like bunnies and chicks and flowers and plants, but also new life brought about because of Jesus Christ. We're going to be talking about him later today and how his life tells a message of Easter. Before we start that, and before we start learning a new song today, I wanted to invite you to do a fun activity with me. Go grab your mom or dad if they're not sitting right by you so that they can help. What we're going to do today is make some instruments. These are my egg shakers. If you have some plastic eggs in your house, these will be perfect for today. If you don't have some plastic eggs in your house, you might want to grab some kind of Tupperware container or a cup that has a lid on it. These will work just fine if you have them. Can you listen? You can make and use your very own with things that you have around the house. Here are some examples of egg shakers that I made. This green one right here is filled with coins. Listen to the sound that the coin shaker makes. Okay, do you have some coins that you could use? This blue egg, I don't want to take it out, is filled with sand that I found from outside my house. Okay, let me make sure I get it closed. Be really careful with your shakers that we don't spill and make a mess. Can you guess what's inside this pink egg? Kind of sounds like sand. It's rice. I don't know if you can see that. You can put rice in an egg, close it really tight, and make an egg shaking sound. Again, if you don't have an egg, you need something else that has a lid that you can put things in. Okay, this orange egg has beans, dried beans inside. Kind of sounds like the coins. This last egg that I have today, my golden egg, is filled with bigger sized rocks. Okay, so press pause in this video to go grab some plastic eggs or another container and pick what you're gonna fill it inside to make some egg shakers for our first activity today. Okay, are you ready to get shaken and move into the beat? Our fun song we're gonna sing is Jesus Wants Me for a Sunbeam. Sounds like this. Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. Every time you say beam or something that rhymes with it, we're gonna pop up and shake our egg shakers fast. Are you ready to try it with me? Get moving and singing and shaking along. Jesus wants me for a sunbeam to shine for an ink each day in everybody try to please him at home, at school, at play. Ready? Here we go. Jesus wants me for a sunbeam to shine for him each day. In every way, try to please him. At home, at school, at play. A sunbeam, a sunbeam. A sunbeam, a sunbeam. Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, a sunbeam. I'll be a sunbeam for him.
Okay.
How did you do?
Switch my shakers around for now. How about this one with rocks
and this one with rice? What did you put in your shaker today? Is it making a cool sound? All right, let's do one more song with our shakers for now. This song is I Am a Child of God. He has sent me here, has given me an earthly home with parents kind and dear. Do you know the words to this one? Ready to shake along? A little bit slower egg shaking beat, huh? Okay, sing and shake. Here we go. I am a child of God.
I am a child of God. And he has sent me here. Has given me an earthly home with parents kind and dear.
Let's shake a little faster. Lead me.
Lead
I love using fun instruments. I'm gonna put these down for now. Will you also please put your egg shaker down for a bit? We're going to learn a song that talks about Jesus Christ at Easter time and tells a really amazing story about his life. Go ahead and sit down and let's get reverent for just a little bit. So like I said, this is an amazing story that we tell along with a song that we're going to learn. Jesus Christ lived a long time ago. He loved Heavenly Father and listened to him and did the things that were good. He had friends that he loved and helped. He used special powers from God to perform miracles for people that were hurt or sick or needed his help. Jesus Christ was the perfect example of looking out and helping other people on the earth, being a good friend and keeping the commandments. Can you remember any stories about good things that Jesus did while he was on the earth? What's something that he did? Jesus did lots of amazing things. Today we're going to learn a song about probably the most amazing thing any person has ever done. Our song says, I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. Listen to that one more time. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. When we sing that, we're saying we're amazed at Jesus' love for us. Can you show me what it looks like to be amazed when something's amazing? What does your face look like? Amazing, right? What's that amazing thing that he did? Let's look at a picture real quick. Will you try to sing this with me? And then we'll talk about what our picture says and does. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers or gives me. Ready? I stand. Here we go. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. What love did he offer us? Like we said, he was a perfect example of showing love. But a really amazing thing that he did is called the atonement. Because he loved us, he suffered for our sins, our sadness, and our pain. For every person that's ever lived, everything bad that's ever happened to us, he has felt. When it was really hard, he prayed to Heavenly Father for help to overcome this hard thing. I'm sure it was really hard. Why would he do that? Let's sing that one more time. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. Ready? I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. Maybe it's a little bit confusing. Why would he do that? Confused. Confused at the grace. What's grace? That's a big word. Grace is a gift he gives to us. Can you show me grace? Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. Proffers means he gives it to us. He gives us love, he gives us grace, so that when we make mistakes, we can think about his example, we can be helped because he suffered for our sins. We'll talk about that more in just a second. Will you try this part with me? Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. Will you try that part with me? We have some big words. Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers or gives me. Okay? Confused. Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. How are you doing so far? You getting the hang of it? Let's sing that part with our shaker real quick. Will you pick up your shaker and we'll put those two parts together? I stand all amazed at the what? Love, who? Jesus offers me. Confused at the grace, can you say grace, that so fully he proffers me. Some big words, I think we can do it. Let's shake and sing along. Ready? I stand. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. You getting the hang of it so far? Okay, we're going to keep telling our story. After Jesus Christ suffered in the Garden of Gethsemane for our sins through the atonement, this next part is pretty sad. Jesus Christ was crucified. This part makes me a little bit sad. The part of this song says, I tremble to know that for me he was crucified. Let's talk about what's happening in this picture. Why was he crucified for us? Have you ever done something that you got in trouble for? Maybe big trouble or had to go to timeout? It's hard to always make good choices. We sin and make mistakes all the time. If we put all the bad things that we did together, we would be in pretty big trouble. Heavenly Father knows this, and he doesn't want us to get in big trouble, and neither does Jesus Christ. Sometimes, a long time ago, people were crucified when they made mistakes and did really bad things. The people living at the time of Jesus Christ didn't understand that he was a good person, and that he suffered, and that he loved them, and did these things for them. They crucified him. And because he was crucified, and atoned and died for us, we don't have to feel those pains and sadnesses and die for our sins. Because he loves us, he suffered on the cross for us. They put nails in his hands and in his feet. He died. He was crucified so he could pay for all the times when we mess up so that we don't have to go through that. Because he loves us, the atonement and the crucifixion are ways that he shows us his love. Let's listen and sing that part one more time. I tremble. That part makes me so sad and amazed. Oh my goodness, I tremble. Can you show me that? Say tremble. I tremble to know that for me, he was crucified. Will you try that part with me? Let's sing it two times. I tremble to know. I tremble to know that for me, he was crucified. Are you getting it okay? Let's do that one more time. I tremble to know. I tremble to know that for me, he was crucified. Isn't this amazing that he would do something so, so hard? He did die on the cross. This picture shows what happened after he died. The people that loved him took his body and prepared it and buried it in a tomb. They put a big round stone in front of the door to cover it so that nobody would disturb him. Okay, here's the last part of our first verse of our song. That for me a sinner, he suffered, like something's really hard, and he prayed for help. That for me a sinner, he suffered, he bled, and died. Okay, listen to how that part sounds. That for me a sinner, he suffered, he bled and died. This is a very serious song, huh? With a beautiful message. Will you try that part with me? That for me a sinner, he suffered, he bled and died. If our story ends there, that seems a little bit sad, huh? That's not the end of our story, though. And this is part of the message of Easter. On the third day after Jesus died, here's the very last part of our story. This is called the resurrection. Can you say that part with me? Say resurrection.
Resurrection means that he lives again. After his atonement, crucifixion, and burial, Jesus rose or came alive again from the tomb. He lived again. The people that he loved were able to see him and speak with him. They touched the prints in his hands, and they felt of his love for them. So this means that our story has a happy ending. The next part of this, that's so wonderful, sounds like this. Oh, it is wonderful that he should care for me enough to die for me. Okay, listen to that one more time. Sing it with me if you know it. It's wonderful, like you can't hold it in. Oh, it is wonderful that he should care for me enough to die for me. Will you try that with me? And right about there, I forgot it cuts off a little bit. Oh, it is wonderful that he should care. Oh, it is wonderful that he should care for me enough to die for me. The next words sound a little bit similar. Oh, it is wonderful, wonderful to me. So this amazing story that we tell is the message of Easter and the message of this song. This hymn is called I Stand All Amazed, and you just learned the whole theme. Can we put it together from the first verse to the chorus? This time, we'll shake our egg shakers along. What do you think's in this egg? This is my coin egg. All right, let's start from the beginning of this song. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me. Do you know what comes next? Confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. See if you can get the words. I know there's a lot of big words. This song is from the green hymn book that we get to sing with in sacrament meetings sometimes. And your parents should know this song too. I tremble, that's so sad to know that for me he was crucified. That for me, a sinner, he suffered, he bled, and died. What happened about this story? It's wonderful that he rose again and that he loves us and did these hard things for us so that we can be resurrected like him. Oh, it is wonderful. Oh, it is wonderful. Okay, we go that he should care for me enough to die for me. It is wonderful, wonderful to me. Are you ready to sing this whole song? Just do the best you can. Shake and sing together. Okay? Let's get the background track. Can you hear the beautiful music to this song? We're going to start from the beginning over here. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me, confused at the grace that so fully he proffers or gives to me. Okay, you stand up, shake and sing. I stand all amazed. I stand all amazed at the love Jesus offers me, oh, a lot slower, confused at the grace that so fully he proffers me. I tremble to know that for me, he was crucified, that for me, a sinner, he suffered, he bled and died. Oh, it is wonderful. Oh, it is wonderful that he should care for me enough to die for me. Oh, it is wonderful. Oh, it is wonderful. Wonderful. Wonderful to me. All right, go ahead and put that egg down for now. Real quick, let's finish off this story. Thank you for learning this song today with me and learning this story about our Easter message. This song makes me feel the Spirit and Jesus' love for me every time that I sing it. Just like new baby chicks, bunnies, and plants that grow in the springtime around Easter, we can celebrate at Easter time new life because Jesus was resurrected. After we die, we can be resurrected. Because he lives, we should be happy and try to be like him and tell other people this wonderful message. Because he lives, someday after we die and our family members die, we can live again. I want you to think of this empty tomb, because he wasn't there any longer. He rose, he is risen. And every time you see this egg, see an egg that's empty, nothing inside of it, right? I want you to remember this empty tomb with nothing inside of it, because Jesus lives. That is a message of Easter. And I want you to think about it every time you celebrate Easter. I know he lives and he loves you. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Please keep practicing this song. We'll bring it back to another episode of Virtual Singing Time again. There's a link in the description below that you can click to practice and listen to this song with your family. Have a wonderful Easter. Happy Easter. Thanks for joining us today. And until next time, goodbye, primary kids.